आई थिंक मिस्टर पवन हैड सम डाउट, बट आई थिंक मिस्टर
वो
पवन
नहीं अभी
हैज,
क्लास, ही इज नॉट इन क्लास।
या ही इज नॉट इन क्लास, सो बीइंग इन द क्लास इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट.
एक्चुअली हिज टाइमिंग इज डिफरेंट ना, ही इज इन यूके सो।
ओके, मे बी. सो ही प्रॉब्ली आस्क दिस क्वेश्चन दैट डिजिटल मार्केटिंग शुड टोटली कम अंडर मर्करी, और देयर शुड बी सम अदर कॉम्बिनेशन अलॉन्ग विथ मर्करी.
Yeah, digital marketing means it comes into both Mercury and Venus. Yeah,
Okay.
so Venus is the thing which attracts the opponent, correct? So anything which attracts the opponent, it comes under the Venus. In general, a notification, everyone knows the term notification, a notification, right? Any notification, any announcement, it comes under the character of Mercury. But when it comes to the advertisement, it comes under the cargo of both Mercury and Venus. Because the advertisement needs some special attraction, right? Special attracting qualities to attract the customers. So that's why anything which attracts the customer on the aspect of beauty or on the aspect of the quality, it comes under the attraction, the law of attraction comes under the Venus.
Right, sir. Right.
Yeah, Mercury is informative. But Venus is attractive.
I
Right?
want to ask,
Yes.
sir, sir, Mercury is drawing, and what about
Okay.
sir, painting? It includes Venus or Mercury or?
It includes both Mercury and Venus. It includes both Mercury Karma and Venus Karma, especially in the painting field. In the lot of the painting field, I have met a lot of wonderful painters.
Art.
Wonderful, yeah, wonderful.
Yes.
The people, wonderful people who've done the drawing professionally in the profession field. They includes both the karmic register of Mercury and Shukra, especially Chitra Nakshatra. There are a lot of art related people, art drawing or painting related people, and Chitra Nakshatra.
Sir, regarding Mercury, I want to say something. Like
Yes.
during my this astrological journey, I met so many astrologers.
Okay.
So one astrologist from South, from Krishnamurti Paditi, he rectified my birth that I'm a scorpion,
Okay.
right? Then again one astrologer came that no, you are in Libra. So then again some say no, you are in Scorpio. So even
Okay.
I feel I am in Scorpio because my Lagna Lord Mars is in Mercury, and I'm typical.
Lagna Lord Mars is in Mercury. It's in which star that Lagna Lord is placed?
Oh, sorry, Rohini,
Rohini
Rohini.
Nakshatra.
Yes.
Ma, that is the Bhadra rectification. Ma, Bhadra rectification is a different topic, and we will take that separately with the example charts. Okay.
Okay.
Bhadra rectification is a great process. So this is not the place here for. Okay. I am asking whether you people have applied the rules and the tips which I have given in the previous class regarding the Mercury Karma Registry, and whether there are clarifications in that. That's what I'm asking.
Sir, I have one doubt, sir.
Yes.
Sir, I am, sir, in previous webinar, I have given my own birth details, sir. I am a Sagittarius ascendant person.
Okay.
I have Mercury, double Mercury Karma. I have previously
Okay.
mentioned Purva Sada star, Lagna point.
Okay.
Moon star in Uttara, sir.
That's okay, sir. What is the clarification which you are having?
Yes, sir. My 7th and 10th Lord Mercury in Pisces, sir. Rahu
Seventh
star.
and tenth Lord Mercury is in Pisces, sir. That's not an issue, but we are not
Sorry,
talking about the planetary placements of Mercury.
yes,
We
one
are
minute, sir.
talking about the karmic registry of Mercury,
Yes,
correct?
sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But you are mentioning the seventh and tenth Lord is Mercury. Mercury can be any house lord. It doesn't matter. What
Yes,
is
sir.
the karmic registry which is expressed, which is revealed by the planet Mercury? Mercury only reveals the Saturn karma, correct?
Yes, sir.
But we are talking about Mercury karma. We are not
Yes, sir.
talking about the planetary placement of Mercury. Am I right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sir, I think we can. Sorry. What is your doubt, sir? I mean, you have explained so much, all right, but then what is the doubt is what sir is asking. If you have a doubt on what we have learned till now, let us discuss that. Otherwise, we must request sir to move on.
Yes, sir. Sir, I have a doubt, sir.
Yes.
Previously, you have mentioned that while I am giving the my birth details, you have mentioned that my 7th and 10th Lord and 6th and 11th Lord were concerned with Venus.
In okay. Paisa,
in Revati Star, you have used the word, oh my God, sir. That is, I need that clarification, sir. Why you have...
What did I mention?
Oh my God.
What? Sir, I can't understand.
Can you type in the chat? Not clearly. Even I cannot understand, actually.
Sir, we cannot understand your question. What is the question?
Okay, sir. Proceed, sir.
No. You can type, sir, in the chat if you want to, because you mentioned okay. That sir had mentioned some term. That term we are not able to understand what exactly you are talking about. So if you can type.
Okay, sir. Chat. I will ask you later, sir. Okay.
Okay. Fine.
Okay, that's okay. So I think the Mercury Karma is almost done in the previous class.
Yes.
Almost.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, Uttara Falguni star is there in Maitrayaj's character?
Uttara Falguni?
Uttara Falguni star is there in Maitrayaj's character?
Mythological character, Lord Arjuna was born in the Uttara Falguni Nakshatra.
Sir, previous class you Uttara Falguni star persons early, I think it is divorced or is there sir, any?
But for that we have to see another karma, the karma of Shukra and the karma of okay. Mars, not only okay. Venus, right?
Okay,
so not only Mercury. So two nakshatras. First one is Rohini nakshatra, Uttara Falguni and Purvashada nakshatra. In general, these three nakshatras carries the karmic registry of Mercury. So these three nakshatras are indicating the other caste, other religion, other language, other race, other community related marriages. The marriages which happen to other religion, the marriages which happen to other community, other caste, the marriages which happen to other language people, other country people, like that, the two different races combined together. Then it creates the Mercury karmic registry, correct?
Yes,
right. We have discussed already, but in the same time, the divorce, right? The divorce or being separated, it also comes under the karmic registry of both Mercury and Shukra karma, Mercury Shukra and Mars karma. So, do you know what is the difference between that in the application of the practical life? While applicating this information in the practical horoscope, you might have get a lot of horoscope which have both the combination of Mercury karma and Shukra karma, both Mercury karma and Mars karma, right? There are two important things for marriage. One is Mars and another one is Shukra. Am I correct, sir?
Yes.
Two important things, right? Yes, so take for an example, a person is carrying the karmic registry like that. Take for an example, a person is Sagittarius Lagna. Okay, the Sagittarius Lagna itself. And the person is the Lagna point stands under Mula Nakshatra. The Lagna point stands under Mula Nakshatra. So Mula Nakshatra carries the karmic registry of Mars. Correct? Okay. And the Lagna Lord Jupiter is placed in the Leo. In the house of Leo. Correct? In the Simha, in the Simha Lagna. And is placed in the Simha Lagna. The Lagna Lord is placed under Uttara Falguni Nakshatra. So Uttara Falguni Nakshatra carries the karmic registry of Mercury. Okay. Then what about Rasi Nakshatra? Under the Rasi Nakshatra is placed in the under Chitra or the Arudra. Then what are all the total karmas carried by the concerned person? Mars, Venus and Mercury. Am I correct?
Yeah, Arudra will be Venus.
Yes. Arudra will be Venus and Mula will be Mars and Uttara Falguni will be the Mercury karmic registry. So the single person, the same concept person is carrying all the three karmic registry. So do you know what is the tips we have to give the concerned person? The concerned person should not get engaged or committed or married to the relationship. Married to the relative. He should not choose a bride or a groom in the family itself. It is the worst combination for the people who choose, who have all the three karmas, Mercury karma, Mars karma, and Shukra karma. If they choose the bride or groom in the same family member itself, in the while like a relationship, like a cousin. My father's elder sister's daughter. It's my cousin, right? Am I correct or not?
Yes. In Hindu culture, we don't marry to our in our own family.
In South India, we do, ma'am.
Yeah, that's fact is different, but even in India,
Maharashtra also allowed, no?
In South India, Maharashtra, Karnataka, and in Muslim culture, they marry each other in the family.
It's happening a lot of relationship marriages. Relationship marriages, I'm not against the marriage which is done within the relative itself. I'm not against that. But for the people who carries the karmic registry of the three planets along together within the single horoscope, the karmic registry of Mercury, the karmic registry of Shukra, Venus, and the karmic registry of Mars. If the three karmic registries is combined to the single chart itself, then we should not encourage that concerned person to choose a groom or bride within the same family, within the bloodline relative. They should not do that.
Yes.
One thing. And another one important thing. Such kind of person, while coming to Shadi, while coming to marry, an important query will ask. Sir, you are advising that the concerned person who carries the karmic registry of Mars, Shukra, or Venus should not choose the person within the relatives. But either we can choose the person who is living abroad. Such doubt will arise, right? But what is the thing? What is the danger? What is the warning fact? Is that the person who carries the karmic registry of Venus, Mercury, and Mars together in the same horoscope, while seeing alliance, while searching for alliance in the abroad country, they might be cheated.
Oh, okay.
Can you understand the point? They will be cheated.
So on what yes. account?
So the alliance which they are searching in the abroad, so that should be very, very trustworthy, right? So the trustworthiness will not be there. The job of the concerned person, concerned bride or concerned group, and the citizenship of the concerned family in the abroad, the legal citizenship, the official, the legal quality, the legal quality and the moral quality of the concerned family, it is not trustworthy. When searching for alliance to the concerned person who carries all the three karmas in the same horoscope, it is very, very dangerous. Correct. So what is the safe thing? That either to get it is not safe to get married in the relative itself, but at the same time it is not safe at all to get married to the unknown family in the abroad. Okay, so it is safe whether to search any bride or groom within our country itself. Doesn't mean that it should be the relative. Correct. Lot of families and lot of alliances are there within our community, apart from our community. So it is based upon the will and wish of the concerned family. They can search alliances within India, within our country, within their country, in which the kid is born. Okay, the hometown or the home country. The limit is the home country. They have to search. Can all people understand my point? What I'm trying to
yes,
deliver?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this is the very important piece of information while coming to marriage related inquiries. I hope so. Right?
A lot of people might. Reason behind that, why in foreign country they will be cheated? Because Mercury is, you said last time, he's settling abroad.
Mercury is not, I didn't mention the Mercury. Mercury
outside
is
country. You said outside Mercury. Country. Other country.
I didn't mention that Mercury is the planet which is the karakatva for settling abroad. I mentioned that Mercury is a planet for identity. Identity, your Aadhaar card, your citizenship, your passport, your visa. Everything comes under Mercury. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes, it might be cheated, right? Because there are a lot of fraudulent activities happening in the case of shadi, in the case of marriages, while searching alliances. The victim will have the combination of all the three karmas, Mars karma, Mercury karma, and Venus karma. So these three karmas, which are elongated in the, which are combinedly affected in the influence in the same chart, that person have to be very, very careful while searching alliances in abroad, in other countries, while searching alliances or while committing with an unknown relationship or unknown family, because we know nothing about the family. We know nothing about the concerned person. Am I correct or not?
Yes.
Yes, the trustworthiness have to be questioned a lot for the persons, because these persons are the affected person. According to my experience, I have seen a lot of horoscope which which carries the three karmic registry within the same chart. Lot of people were cheated, especially girls, even boys were cheated while coming to the marriages. Okay.
Yes, sir. That is, sir, in the example that you gave, yes. Venus, Mars was in Arudra and Venus was in which star, sir?
Mars is not in Arudra. I'm talking about, I mentioned only the Rati Nakshatra in Arudra.
Okay.
Yeah. And Lagna point is in Mula. Lagna Lord is in Uttar Falguni Nakshatra and Rati Nakshatra in Arudra, just for an example.
Understood.
Sir, in this combination, can we also take seventh lot? Let's say in the three combination, Venus, Mars, yes, and Mercury, we get, yes, only two.
Okay.
And the third one is coming from the seventh lot nakshatra.
Yes, we can take up to some extent.
Yeah, just thinking, like, you know, in case there are such combinations.
We can take up to some extent. And another most important thing is, I am researching a current topic under the Mercury Karma Registry, because this is a doubt for a lot of students, even my Tamil following students. What is the Bhava for Mercury Karma Registry? They are asking me repeatedly for Mercury and Venus Karma. For Mercury Karma, I am keeping working on it. And I'm sensing the fourth bhava sometimes influences a lot in Mercury Karma. Not directly, but indirectly.
Okay.
Because the fourth bhava is the bhava of Vidya. Am I correct?
Yes,
it's the bhava,
yes,
of,
sir,
education.
Yes.
Correct? The fourth, yes, bhava comes under the, what are all the karakatvas of Mercury, main karakatvas of Mercury is concluded in the fourth bhava. So fourth bhava sometimes, up to some extent, it influences the karmic registry of Mercury. That is why I have seen a lot of charts in which the seventh lord is placed in the fourth house, or fourth lord is placed in the seventh house. Especially the seventh lord is placed in the fourth house, or fourth lord is placed in the seventh house. In that particular chart, whether if the concerned person carries the karmic registry of Mercury, Shukra, and Mars, their marital life will be very, 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 very miserable. It leads to divorce, it leads to separation.
Yes.
I also seen, matlab, 2-3 chart I also seen. Seventh lord in fourth, divorce cases is,
yes, more. Seventh lord is in the fourth house, or fourth lord is in the seventh house. Because Mercury karma leads to divorce. Correct? If the same, under the same family, the concerned person, he himself carries the karmic registry of Shukra, Mars and Mercury, then it is very, very worst. So this is the first group I'm revealing the bhava for Mercury Karma Registry. That too I'm researching only. This is not final. Okay. But I'm researching because I need a lot of evidence. I need a lot of charts. We need a lot of charts.
So if Mars and Venus is there, and plus if we say seventh lord and fourth lord have any connection, then also it leads to some sort of...
Mars, here you have to understand one important thing, Ma. We are not talking about the planetary placement of Mars and Venus.
No, Mars and Shukra karma plus, okay, seventh and fourth lord combination.
Even though the concerned person have to be careful.
Okay.
Yes, the concerned person have to be very, very careful. And the relationship marriage should not be encouraged. But the marriages which is related to other community can be encouraged. It can be done.
So just a food for thought.
Sir.
Fourth, yes, house is the house of mother. So probable, okay. I mean, I'm just speaking my heart out.
Okay.
Maybe the mother's influence will create a difficulty or disturbance in the relationship.
Mother's influence, which is affecting the marital life, is a different combination. It is about the combination of Chandra Karma.
Chandra Karma. Correct?
Yes, take an example as an horoscope, because we are talking about the marital related issues. So it is also under syllabus only.
Sure,
okay.
Take
the Lagna of Libra. Libra, ascendant. Everyone listening to me? Every people?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes,
sir. Okay, just for confirmation. Take for an example, Lagna. Libra. Kula ascendant. Okay.
Yeah.
The seventh lord, Mercury. Seventh lord Mars is placed in the seventh house itself. Correct. Already the Lagna, the Libra Lagna, the Lagna itself is the Moola Trikona house of Venus.
Venus.
Correct. So the Libra Lagna itself carries the karmic registry of Moon.
Moon.
Am I correct?
Moon.
So what are all the bhavas which gives the karmic registry of Moon?
Sixth lord and seventh lord.
Under the case of the Libra Lagna, the seventh lord itself is Mars. Am I correct? The seventh lord itself is Mars. The
seventh lord is Shukra.
Libra Lagna.
Okay.
Seventh lord is Aries. Seventh house is Aries, right?
Okay.
We are talking about the Libra ascendant, ma'am. Miss Sangeeta?
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yes, the seventh lord Mars is placed in the Aries itself, in the seventh house itself. Then what does it mean? Seventh lord is placed in the seventh house itself. Then the seventh lord will carry the karmic registry of Moon or not?
Moon.
According to Baba.
Correct.
According to Baba, it will carry the karmic registry of Moon.
Moon itself.
Take in another example, the seventh lord is placed under Bharani Nakshatra. What is it? Indicate.
Triple moon.
Double and triple moon. So the Lagna itself carries the karmic registry of Chandra Bhagavan, and the seventh lord Mars is carrying the karmic registry of Moon. Okay,
yeah.
You just imagine in that particular chart, the Lagna point stands under Chitra Nakshatra.
Okay. Venus and triple moon.
Every people following me.
Voice,
the... Ashton kid.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. The Lagna is Libra, and the Lagna point stands under Chitra Nakshatra. The Lagna point stands under Chitra Nakshatra. The seventh lord, Mars is in the seventh house itself. It is under Bharani Nakshatra.
Yeah.
Correct? So, the Lagna have the impact of both Chandra Karma and Venus Karma. The seventh lord has the impact of two Chandra Karma. Correct. Now, the concerned person has to be very, very careful while handling the relationship between the wife and the mother.
Yes, sir. Very true.
If it is the balance should be very pakka managed. It should be very, very clear-cutly it should be managed. If it is a simple slap in that, if it is a simple fault in that, then the entire house will get a quarrel, a big quarrel.
Yes.
I have seen a lot of people whose ascendant is Libra and the seventh lord is placed in the seventh house itself. The quarrel is based on the kids. The quarrel between the mother-in-law.
Mother-in-law.
And the wife.
Yes.
Sorry. The quarrel between the concerned person's mother and concerned person's wife is based on the kids in the house. Do you know why? Because Mars itself is the second lord. Not only seventh lord.
Yes.
For a Libra ascendant. Every people are following me.
Yes.
And it has got Jupiter karma.
Yes, sir.
Yes. It got the Jupiter karma. Correct? For a Libra ascendant, Mars, it has two houses. The second house is Scorpio and the seventh house is Aries. The second Bhava indicates the Jupiter karma. Yes. And the seventh Bhava, Aries, indicates the Moon karma. Correct? So the second lord and the seventh lord, Mars, is commonly placed in the seventh house. So it gives Jupiter karma and Moon karma to both the houses.
Yeah.
To the seventh house itself. to the seventh house itself. Correct?
Yes.
So this is the combination, the mother's emotion, the mother's wrong decision that affects the family life of the concerned person. It can be either a male's chart or a female's chart. It doesn't matter. Okay? The mother's wrong guidance or wrong conclusion or wrong decision or wrong approach that betrays the marital life of the concerned person. This type of combination.
Very true. So I have seen many cases like this. Mothers influencing and mothers becoming probably, you know, an indirect or direct reason for marital problems.
Yes. Okay.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
One question, sir. One yes. doubt. Is it what you're telling now only applicable to Libra ascendant?
It is not. I just mentioned the Libra ascendant as an example.
Okay.
It is generally applicable to a lot of ascendants in which the seventh house itself carries the karmic registry of moon, both the first house and seventh house.
Oh. Okay, right? First house and seventh house.
Okay. So everyone clear with this point?
Yeah, sir. I have one chart.
What I see this is anybody who has got moon and Jupiter karma. Whatever the lagna, whatever the moon rashi, whatever is the combination, will have this problem.
Yes.
Not just the Libra, but anybody.
Okay. Yes. So why Jupiter involved in that?
Jupiter because of the children.
Because Mars is the second lord.
The second
Baba in common, it gives the karmic history of Jupiter that we are going to discuss in the Jupiter karma in detail. The Jupiter karma is our
upper. Why Jupiter creates conflict between them?
Jupiter is just a topic. what is the karma of Jupiter? Jupiter is the karma of kids, correct?
Yes.
That's another important thing. For Libra ascendant, Scorpio is the second house. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Well, then what is the second lord? Second house lord?
Mars.
What is the seventh house lord? Mars. So the second house and the seventh house is a common dealership or common ownership of Mars. That particular Mars is placed in the seventh house.
Okay.
We can also take that the second lord is placed in the seventh house. We can take that in that aspect also. Correct?
Yes.
Okay. Then what if the second lord is placed in the seventh house? Second lord gives guru karma. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Oh, if the second lord is placed in the seventh house, then it will reflect the guru karma to the seventh house or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, that is why he's including the guru karma. That's it. But mainly we are focusing on the marital life and marital life state. And before that, I have to conclude that the fourth house. The fourth house is not yet been concluded for Mercury Karma Registry. I mentioned here only for the divorce or the relationship related issues. Okay, I'm researching on it because I need a lot of evidences. Because I have to admit one important thing is that recently I used to get one horoscope. I will publish that horoscope in the group itself. The first time in my life I met I got a horoscope, and the person is already. Already dead. The person doesn't exist now. At present, the person is person died expired to died 2 years before in 2018. I got the horoscope from a customer. Do you know what? The concerned person, she is a female. She is a lady. She is a housewife. She is murdered by the hands of her husband. Everyone is listening to me.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
The concerned lady, she's murdered to death by the hands of her husband itself. Husband murdered the concerned lady. I got the chart. This is the first time I'm getting this kind of chart. So when I'm taking classes, you students might have asked me, sir, what is the karmic registry for death, sir, for murder and crimes? For that, I have to address minimum 500 charts regarding to murder death. correct? Without that, I can't speak with confidence. Am I correct or not?
Yes.
First, I have to collect the evidences. So this is the first chart I'm getting in my lifetime.
Yeah.
Murder, death. Yeah, I have seen a lot of charts for the people who were suicided. Okay, I have seen a lot of charts, the people who were died by accidents. For that combination, I have seen a lot of chart. This is the first time I'm seeing the chart regarding the person who is murdered by the husband itself. So this is the first time. So from the single chart, I can take a combination. I need a lot of evidences for that. So I have to collect a lot of the related incident happened in the concerned person's life, and I have to collect the concerned person's chart, and I have to analyze what are all the similar patterns in the chart, and after that only a rule will be created. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Astrology is not that much easy. Okay, learning a rule is easy, but creating a rule is not that much easy. Okay. So one thing,
if Mars karma is there and 7-11 combination is there, so the partner will instigate into fights?
It is not that partner will instigate into fight. It is the concerned person will not choose the partner correctly. It is a blame of the concerned person. It is the accusation of the concerned person. He should have choose the partner wrongly. That's why the fight is being happened.
And anyway, he has chosen, then fight. If in a relation there will be some quarrel and all that, that's from the opponent or from the concerned person.
That's what sir said. It's from the concerned person.
Is the video available?
Yeah. Can you hear me?
Okay. Yes, the video is available. Is it running?
Yeah.
Okay. I think some technical problem. Okay. I have seen a lot of charts with 7-11 combination, with 1-7-11 combination. That person, they are not choosing the life partner in the right time, in a right way. Like I have already mentioned in the previous class itself.
I think hang.
I can't hear you, sir.
No man.
I have seen a lot of 1-7-11 combination people. They are choosing the partner. They are searching the partner only in the commercial aspect. Mm.
Yes.
Correct?
Yes, sir.
So if you search a partner for a commercial aspect, for commercial benefits, then what will you get? You will get the commercial benefits. Then what about the relationship? The relationship won't exist for long. Okay. So a relationship is only based on dharma. Relationship is only based on attachment or bonding. Relationship is doesn't based on the commercial aspects. Commercial aspect is a foundation requirement. We do address that. But apart from that, the moral character and the moral behavior of the concerned person is very, very important while choosing a bride or choosing a groom. Am I right?
Sir, what about character of, groom or bride? I mean, sometimes we get a lot of chart before marriage. It comes kind of under matchmaking, but sometimes they also want to know, because in cases like today, there's a lot of after marriage affairs and all that. So do we have any kind of that combination?
But after marriage is, after marriage affairs. So there are, in affairs, there are two kinds. One is legal and another one is illegal. But I hope that government put an order in this recent days that everything is legal. Correct?
Yeah.
The court have given a judgment that everything is legal. So the civilization and the administration and the politics and the politicians who rule the country will change the rules according to the flow of the society. But we astrologers, we have to update the Karagatva according to the flow. That is our fate. What to do? Okay. So the extramarital affair, okay, the extramarital affair is influenced by two planets. So one is a ninth bhava and another one is a 12th bhava. Ninth bhava, ninth lord, 12th bhava and 12th lord. When it combines with the seventh house, first house or seventh house?
Yes, sir, we can hear you.
Bhava is bed and for ninth.
What is that?
12th bhava is sleep, bed, like that or what?
179,
1712. So what ninth house exhibit in this marriage and 12th house?
What is the karma exhibited by the ninth house?
Rahu and Ketu.
So what is the karma exhibited by the 12th house?
Ketu.
Sun.
Surya karma. So Surya karma and Rahu karma is responsible for extramarital affair and extramarital relationship. Surya karma and Rahu karma is responsible for more than a single marriage. It can be a second marriage or it can be a third marriage.
It can be fourth marriage also, no, Sandro?
Yes, it can be fourth marriage also. Now, that's what I stated. It is more than a single marriage. That's it. The limit should be decided by the concerned person, not by the horoscope.
Sir, Ardra, you state premarital affairs.
That is premarital. Yes. Now we are talking about postmarital.
Yes, but after marriage also, Ardra can create problem.
It is a problem which is related to the husband and wife relationship, not extramarital. Extramarital, we should have the combination of Surya Karma and Rahu Karma. At least one. Either Rahu Karma and Surya Karma. Among the two, at least one we should have. Because in the first class itself, I have stated three nakshatras, which carries the karmic registry of more than a single marriage. What are all the three nakshatras? Anyone noted that point in the first video? Pushya nakshatra,
Ashwini,
Asilesha, and Purabhadra. Pushya, Asilesha, and Purabhadra.
So why Ashlesha and Purabhadra?
Because these three nakshatras carries a karmic registry of more than a single marital life.
I'm still waiting, sir. I'm Ashlesha and looking forward to.
Pushya can be confirmed. I can confirm Pushya.
Pushya can be confirmed. What is the things happening between them? I can't understand the...
Some charts and their Pushya is not marital affair. Means life is good.
They are not married,
Married, but sometime they divorce 3 years, 4 years, and then after they really collected.
Okay. These three nakshatras, the people who were born repeatedly under three nakshatras, the family hold the karmic registry of more than a single marriage. Okay, but we have to narrow down the combination for the people who, for the concerned person who himself is doing more than a single marriage. For that only, I have mentioned the combination of 179 or 1712. Okay?
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Okay.
And another most important combination is 17 with Guru and Ketu. Everyone says that Guru and Ketu gives us a sannyasa yoga. It's not.
Sir, Guru and Ketu. Saturn, Guru, Ketu give no sannyasa. I think Saturn.
One doubt, sir.
Guru, in general, Guru and Ketu gives. They are responsible for more than a single marriage.
You are talking about Guru and Ketu as a planet, or Guru or Ketu as a
Guru
karma?
Guru and Ketu as a planet, because take for an example, Guru and Ketu is placed in the seventh house, correct? So it aspects the first house itself. If the Guru and Ketu is placed in the Lagna itself, it aspects the seventh house. So 17 with Guru and Ketu. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Right. Correct. So what is the karmic registry provided by Guru?
Rahu.
And what is the karmic registry provided by Ketu?
Okay. Surya. Okay. Sun. Okay. Now got it. Okay.
So that is abundance. Why I have mentioned that Guru Ketu is not sannyasa yoga.
Yeah, I also have that.
I have, sir, one chart. Guru Ketu in 12th house. Okay. Guru Ketu in 12th house.
Guru Ketu is
12th house, I have, sir.
Now slowly everybody is coming out, sir.
Yes.
Okay.
12th house.
So we have to be very, very certain with what we are talking, right? We are talking about the DNA of the DNA connectivity of the extramarital. Okay. For more than a single marriage. For that, I have already mentioned the three stars. Pushya, Asilisha and Purubhadra. So the people who have Rasi Nakshatra or Lagna Point or Lagna Lord standing Nakshatra repeatedly under a single family within these three Nakshatras. So that family only carries the pattern of more than a single marital life. So this thing we have to be clear. Under that particular family, the person who have the combination of 179 or 179 and 12, or else the person who have the combination of 17 Guru and Ketu. So that's that person have the that person might face the combination of the extra marital affair or more than a single marriage. Clear? Everyone clear with this?
Yes, sir, then he can run matrimony business.
Huh? How is this coming now?
Matchmaking.
Matrimony business is different. Okay. They're different. For matrimony business, mainly you have to have two karmic registries. Especially you have to have the powerful karmic registry of Shukra. Shukra karma registry.
And for Mercury Venus also. Karma. And Mercury also, yes. Right?
Yeah, the Mercury also, and Venus.
But Venus will be very, very predominant.
Yes.
And after that, only Mercury. Because Mercury is a registration right. center, because it is a social networking site. But Venus will be very, very powerful in for the person who is running the matrimony portal or matrimony agency.
Yeah, the main karaka.
Yes. Oh. So take for an example, a person is constructing a marriage hall. A person is constructing a marriage hall, okay? And he's providing the hall for rent and he's gaining the income from that. For commercial purpose. He constructed a hall, marriage hall, and he's providing the hall for rent and he's gaining income from that hall. Then what are all the karma combinations for the concerned person's business?
The Mars will come.
Mars, Venus.
Yes. Mars karma and Mercury karma. Mars karma and Venus karma.
Venus karma.
The combination of both Mars. Two karmas to the, especially to the 10th house.
Right.
Profession. Like, yeah, and the 10th Lord or the 10th Baba point might be placed under the Arudra Chitra and Shravana Nakshatra.
Yes.
And 11th Lord combines to the 10th house at the same time. Or Saturn combines to the 10th house. So the combination of Mars Karma and Mercury Karma to the same house, to the same 10th house. Even to the Lagna also. 110 and Mars and Mercury karma. It gives a powerful
combination. It is suitable Simha Lagna person. Sir, it is suitable Simha Lagna person.
Why you are connecting the Simha Lagna to that?
9th Lord and 10th Lord.
9th Lord and 10th Lord. The 9th house is Aries and 10th house is Taurus. I'm correct. But we are talking about the karmic registry, not the house, not the ownership.
Okay.
Correct. Okay. So any clarifications apart from this regarding the Venus karma? Mercury karma?
No, sir.
No. Okay. No, sir. So the Mercury karma is finished.
Yes, sir.
Can we go to the next topic?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So today, after the Wednesday, what is the day? Thursday.
Thursday. Right? Yes.
So now we are moving to the karmic registry of Jupiter.
Jupiter.
So Jupiter is also another important headache in every person's life. Because, yes, because the two major important things every human being will suffer is, one is money, commercial problem, economical problem, and another one is kids and children.
Children.
Yes. So these are the two important headaches a concerned person cannot escape from his life. Right? So that path is covered by the karmic registry of Jupiter. Okay. So what are all the nakshatras which gives the karmic registry of Jupiter?
Vrikshara.
Uttarshada. Okay. Megasirisha, Hasta, and Uttarshada. The birth star of, what is the birth star of planet Moon?
Mrigshira.
Okay. Then what is the birth star of planet Sun?
Hasta.
What is the birth star of planet Mars?
Uttarshada.
Okay, so Moon is born under the Mrigasirisha Nakshatra, Sun is born under the Hasta, and Mars is born under the Uttarshada Nakshatra. Am I correct? Okay, yes, so these three planets, the planets itself carries the karmic strength or the karmic registry of Jupiter. Correct?
Yes.
Everyone following me, because I can't hear.
Yes,
the
sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. So, in according to the aspect of traditional astrology, when a problem arises or any problem want to get resolved, usually we expect the aspect of Jupiter, correct? The vision of Jupiter. When Jupiter views, our papa will get mukti.
Yeah, when Jupiter, auspicious. Yeah,
yes, the Jupiter. Yes, the Jupiter's vision is very auspicious. When Jupiter aspect a particular bhava, the bhava will get neutralized. The bhava will get eliminated from the problems which creates for the concerned person. So that is what we are defined by the traditional astrology. But what I'm asking is the power of Jupiter, the karmic strength of Jupiter, the real power of Jupiter is expressed by either the planet Jupiter or these three planets.
These three, sir.
Yes. Moon, Sun, and Mars.
But are we talking about the karmic registry of Jupiter?
Yes. So, take for an example, what is the aspect of Mars? What are all the aspects of Mars?
4 and 8, sir. 4, 7, and 8.
Yeah. Through that fourth aspect, seventh aspect, and eighth aspect, Mars is aspecting that planet's own energy, or Mars is aspecting emitting the Guru Karma.
Guru Karmas.
Okay. Yes. Then what about the aspect of Moon?
Same. Sir.
Then what about the aspect of Sun?
Same.
Guru Karma. So what are all the energy we need from the Guru? It doesn't provided by the planet Guru itself. It is provided by these three planets. Arnab sir, can you understand the concept?
Yeah, but still little unclear actually.
Yes,
so,
yes sir, you can ask the clarification. Yes.
No, so you are saying that when we are to look for Jupiter karma, say Mars is in any house, okay, so it will have its own drishti, Mars drishti. So you are saying those drishtis are equivalent to Jupiter karma on those houses? Yes. It's giving Jupiter karma.
Yes.
Okay, that was my doubt. Okay, thank you.
Yes. So the karma, it includes both positive and negative, right? It includes both positive and negative,
right?
But when but in here in DNA astrology, we are taking the positive aspects of the karma to improve in our life, correct? When Mars is aspecting the 10th house, what is the, how will you define that? Take for an example, Mars is placed in the fourth house, and Mars is aspecting the 10th house. Seventh aspect, the drishti of Mars is aspecting the 10th house. Does the power of Mars is dominating the 10th house, or the karma of Jupiter is influencing the 10th house?
Jupiter karma and teaching.
Jupiter.
Yes. Jupiter. Does the concept person have the power of Guru with it connected with the 10th house through the aspect of Mars?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. Along with Mars, if Moon is placed in the 4th house, and Moon is also aspecting the 10th house, then the power of
intensifies,
will increase. The density of the aspect will increase. Then what about if the Surya Bhagavan, Chandra Bhagavan, and Kuja Bhagavan, Mars Bhagavan, is placed in the 4th house, and all the three planets aspect the 10th house?
Renowned professors.
The density of the Guru power, right, is large. So the concerned person can choose the field of Jupiter.
Yes.
Jupiter profession, the profession which is related to Jupiter, it can be any finance or any teaching or education related profession or training related profession. He can excel in that. Take for an example, in my chart, my chart is Dhanu Lagna, and my Mars is placed in the fourth house. I hope everyone know about my chart.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
My Mars is placed in the fourth house, and another most important thing is my Mars is the fifth lord.
Yes. Dhanu Lagna, Mars.
Yes. So, what are the Bhavas which gives the karmic energy of Jupiter? So, do you know what is the Moola Trikona house of Mars?
Aries.
The Moola Trikona house of Mars is Aries. What is the Moola Trikona? Yeah, the Moola Trikona house of Moon, Chandra Bhagavan.
Taurus.
Taurus. The Moola Trikona house of Moon is Taurus. Okay. What is the Moola Trikona house of Surya Bhagavan?
Leo.
Okay. So, the Aries, the house that itself carries the karmic energy of Jupiter, correct?
Yes, sir.
So,
1, 2, 5.
Yes. Taurus is the house that carries the karmic energy of Jupiter, and Leo is the house that carries the karmic energy of Jupiter. So, Jupiter and Karma have three houses. According to Kal Purusha, three Bhavas. One,
Aries, Leo, and
five. Yes. Aries, Leo, Aries, Taurus, and Leo.
Aries, Taurus, Leo.
And Leo. Okay. And according to the Kal Purusha, it is the first Bhava, second Bhava, and fifth Bhava.
First, second, and fifth
Bhava. Yes. First house, second house, and fifth house. So these are the three houses which carries the karmic registry of Jupiter. You might have already noted down the three planets. Sun, Moon, and Mars carries the karmic energy of Jupiter. Correct?
These are the houses and then the Rashis.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So, in my chart, in my Sagittarius ascendant chart, the Saturn is placed in the Lagna itself. Correct? I'm a Sagittarius ascendant. Saturn is placed in the Lagna itself. My Mars is placed in the fourth house. And the Lagna Lord Jupiter is placed in the sixth house. Everyone knows that. Correct?
Yes, sir.
My Lagna Lord is placed in the sixth house. Jupiter is placed in the sixth house. Saturn is placed in the Lagna. And my Mars is placed in the Pisces. It is placed in the fourth house. So, what are all the common Bhava which is aspected by Saturn, Mars, and Jupiter? So Saturn have three aspects.
Seven. And
3, 7, 10. Okay. When the Saturn is placed in the Lagna, it will aspect the 10th house. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. When the Mars is placed in the 4th house, it will aspect the 10th house as the 7th drishti, 7th vision.
Yes, sir.
Okay. When the Jupiter as a first lord, as a Lagna lord, it is placed in the sixth house. It is aspecting the fifth drishti to the 10th house.
Yes, sir.
So all the first lord, second lord, and fifth lord are aspecting to my 10th house. That is why teaching profession is successful for me.
Okay.
Also, Taurus also have Jupiter karma. Right?
Taurus also have Jupiter karma. Moreover, my 10th Lord Mercury is placed under Hasta Nakshatra. Hasta Nakshatra, the Nakshatra itself carries the karmic energy of Jupiter.
Moon. Jupiter. Yes. Guru karma.
Yes. So that is the thing. Right? So under the Jupiter karma, we have two important influences. We have two important challenges which is handled by the concerned person. One is the very most important challenge is Putra Bhakya. Right?
Yes,
pregnancy.
Sir.
Pregnancy, getting pregnant, getting conceived, giving birth to a child, getting an offspring. Correct? Giving birth to another generation. So the Putra Bhakya, the Putra Dosha, the Putra Bhakya is the main concern of the Jupiter karmic registry. Okay. So, what are all the combinations for the people who do not have kids, even after getting married, after marriage, even after more than 5 to 10 years, 3 to 4 years, 3 to 5 years, and what are all the combinations? Can anyone guess that?
I think it should be sixth house.
Saturn, Jupiter, Jupiter, Ketu.
So there are totally three bhavas. There are totally three bhavas which gives the karmic registry of Jupiter. One is the first house, second house, and fifth house. Okay.
1, 2, 5.
Okay.
Yes.
1, 2, 5.
Yeah. Take the Libra ascendant itself. Already I intimated that. Libra ascendant. Okay. Take an example. Libra ascendant. Under that Libra ascendant, in the Lagna itself, Saturn is placed. Saturn is placed in the Lagna itself. Okay?
Okay.
So what is the value of Saturn? It is exalted. Am I correct?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
What about the Bhava status? Fifth Bhava, the fourth Bhava, and the fifth Bhava, the Kendra Sthana and the Pura Punya Sthana is exalted in the Lagna itself.
Yes,
correct?
Sir.
Yes.
Okay. What is the comment? What is the feedback will be as a perspective of traditional astrology when it's the fifth lord is exalted in the Lagna itself?
It is very good.
Child will be famous or something like that.
Yes. The concerned person will not. The concerned person will not have a child itself. Why? Why it is happening? Because the fifth bhava is placed in the first house. The first house itself it carries the karmic registry of Jupiter.
Jupiter.
Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
What if the fifth bhava is placed in the fifth house?
Same.
Again, same. It is the same. The fifth, karmic registry of Jupiter will affect the fifth house. What if the fifth bhava is placed in the second house? Or second lord is placed in the fifth house.
So combination between these three houses, basically.
Yes. 1, 5, 2, 5, 1, 2, 1, 2, 5.
So it will get a dosha of basically Jupiter karma.
Yes. Only for the family which carries the powerful guru karma. The family for which the people who are repeatedly getting birth under Mirgashirsha, Mirgashira Nakshatra, Hasta Nakshatra, and Uttarshada Nakshatra. The family which people, either the Lagna Point or Lagna Lord or Rasi Nakshatra, which carries the Mirgashirsha Nakshatra, Hasta Nakshatra, and Uttarshada Nakshatra repeatedly. That particular family is carrying the curse, carrying the karmic registry of Putra Dosha, of Jupiter Karma. Under that particular family, there will be one or two victimized person, affected person. Now we are analyzing the horoscope of the concerned person who is not getting tired. Correct? So this is the combination.
So one question then comes, because in modern technology now you can have child if for people like this. I have a few friends actually who, so here basically Rahu or something needs to come into the picture to take them out of it.
Definitely.
Okay.
Definitely Rahu and Budhan Karma also have to come to picture. I hope so.
Okay. Okay. So can you speak about that a bit, if you have seen chart of such people like how?
For Buddha, especially, I have seen a lot of persons who have artificial insemination.
Most common thing which people are going today to solve this issue.
Yes, artificial insemination, but I won't recommend that it is a healthy thing. But somewhat, up to some extent, it gives some solution. That artificial insemination carries the karmic registry of both Jupiter, Rahu, and Mercury.
Hmm.
Jupiter, Rahu, and Mercury. Especially, it carries two nakshatras. One is Rohini Nakshatra and another one is Kritika Nakshatra. Actually, Kritika Nakshatra carries the karmic disease of Mars. But I have seen a lot of, family patterns under the family. A lot of people were doing the artificial insemination or adopting a child like that.
Kritika has that thing.
Right? Yes, the Kritika has the thing because the Kritika angels, the six Kritika angels, they adopted Lord Muruga, Lord Kartikeya from Shiva. Correct? And Rogini, the Krishna itself, he is an adopted son.
Right, right.
Not Krishna. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So the combination of Rohini Nakshatra and Kritika Nakshatra under the same family, right? Under the same family, it's these kind of happenings have happened. But in this Jupiter karma, in this Putra Dosha karma, there is also another very, very important sensitive combination. Every people might not note it down. Do you know what that is? In a lot of families, voluntary abortion is happening.
Yes.
Voluntary abortion is happening. That too, the voluntary abortion is happening due to the medical scam.
Okay.
Due to medical scam. Take for an example, a husband wife is living together. The wife is getting conceived. And after 2 to 3 months of getting conceived, she is going to a hospital for any scan or for any health general health checkup. In that particular hospital, and the concerned physician or the concerned doctor is recommending the concerned lady to do some test, like a blood test or a urine test like that. Under the blood test or urine test, if the concerned doctor identifies that the child's DNA carries the Down syndrome problem.
Okay.
Child's DNA carries Down syndrome problem. Okay. Or any autism problem, any DNA related problem.
So, any medical condition.
Yeah. Without any further medical investigation, without any proper medical investigation, without any proper confirmation, they themselves will come to a conclusion. It might be false. It might be a false conclusion. The child might be healthy in the future. Right. But without coming to a proper medical investigation, the misguidance, right, the misleading or misconclusion of the doctor will lead the concerned lady or the concerned parent to abort the particular child. Are you noting it down?
Yes, sir.
Because I'm not sure that everybody can understand the thing which I'm trying to deliver.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Guidance we can understand.
Medical, doctors. Misguidance through doctors.
Yes, yes, yes. It is the misguidance through the medical field. It is the misguidance by the medical scam. Misguidance by the doctors. Immature doctors. Okay. Due to the misguidance of the immature doctors, the womb of the zygote of the concerned lady is getting aborted compulsorily, okay, voluntarily, not it is not a miscarriage, it is a voluntary abortion, but the child might be healthy in the future, who knows about that. So due to these kind of medical scams, the concerned person's, the lady's physique will be affected. And after that, she might can get conceived later, more than 3 years, more than 5 years. Correct? Because this is the first baby. This is the first conceiving. If the first conceiving is get aborted while 3 months, then the physique should get the stamina. The physique should get ready. It will get ready only after 6 to 9 months. And after that, they have to prepare for the second child. And after that, there are a lot of medical complications. And due to this, the pregnancy and the giving birth to the concerned baby process, it will get delayed. Correct? So these kind of combination is happening due to two karma combinations. One is guru karma, Another one is Surya Karma, especially Aswini Nakshatra.
So the 12th Lord gets connected to the 5th Bhava like that?
Yes. 12th Lord gets connected to the 6th house. Even the 12th Lord is get connected to the 6th house and the 5th Bhava is in the 5th house itself. Correct.
Okay. 12th Lord in the 6th house, 6th Lord in the 5th house. You're saying.
6th Lord in the 5th house. Even the 5th Lord is in the 2nd house like that. Both the Jupiter and Surya are karma combination to the 5th house. To the 5th house and the 6th house. So in that kind of ladies, that kind of pregnant ladies, they have to be very, very careful. First of all, with the doctors itself.
They have Why to be we careful. Have taken 6th house?
Because the 6th house is a health issue, right?
Okay. And sometimes, sir, if both the husband and wife are not willing to have child, they also go to the go for abortion.
That is their own will and wish, ma. We are not talking about that. We are talking about only the child is getting voluntary aborted due to unnecessary medical misconclusion.
Yes, and if both are voluntary to abort, then also this combination.
This is not the combination. In general, guru karma combination is playing with them. That is what I am trying to say. In general, guru karma combination is playing with them. I have seen a lot of couples. They themselves abort the child.
Yes. Yes.
Right. So that is their own decision. That is their own prapta. But what I'm trying to say is general abortion is different. That means there are two types of abortion. One is the concerned person is aborting the child before the shape is. Before the bone structure is formed. Before the baby's shape and size perception is formed. The abortion is done in the zygote level itself. Then that won't influence a lot. But after 2 to 3 months, if you are aborting a child, it is not an abortion. It is almost equal to a murder. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Because after 3 months, in the third month itself, the heartbeat will arise. After the completion of the 3 months, the heart will completely form. The valves all will completely form. The entire body structure will get completed. Correct? Including our backbone. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Why aborting the second of month, while aborting at the end of the second month or at the end of the third month, if you do abortion, then it is not an abortion. It is literally a murder. Correct? So such kind of misguidance, such kind of misconclusion is happening only by the immature doctors or only through the medical field. Okay? So the person who have both the karmic registry of Surya and Guru, they have to be very, very careful while handling these type of issues. That's how I'm concluding this.
Sir, what about, sir?
The combination of both Surya Karma and Jupiter Karma.
Vishalji, one doubt, sir.
Yes. But I can't see the face of Mr. Krishna Sai. I'm just hearing the voice.
Sir, poor network problem, sir.
Okay.
Sir, is Jupiter Karma is before marriage abortion.
Before marriage abortion means it doesn't only include the Jupiter Karma. It also includes another planet's karma, that is Shukra Karma.
Shukra.
Right, because it leads to premarital affair. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So we can take that Shukra Karma, Guru Karma, and Surya Karma. All the three karma combinations.
Can we term Kunti as one of them?
Kunti didn't abort it, right?
No, I'm saying she had a before marriage pregnancy, right?
Before marriage.
Different, but aborted is different.
No, I'm not saying. I'm just asking, sir. not talking about abortion.
Before marriage, pregnant, it also includes, but the story of Kunti is different. I hope so. It is due to
he's talking about Karna.
Yes. It is the divine power, but Shukra Karma is different. Shukra Karma is about premarital sexual affair.
Okay.
Right. But Kunti didn't get conceived by premarital sexual affair. It is
divine. It is
completely by two karma. Only so one is Surya Karma and Jupiter Karma. She have misused that. Because she is already informed that before marriage you should not test the mantra. But in spite of that, she tested the mantra.
Yeah.
Right. So that is the wrong thing she have done. So that might include both the karmic register of Surya and Jupiter.
Jupiter.
But we don't know the horoscope. And
Absolutely. Yes, sir.
Right. So that's why we can't come to a conclusion with evidence. All we need is a record, right? Because Mercury is a record.
Sir, I have a small question further to this.
Yes.
There is a girl about 18 to 20. And she conceived.
Okay.
Did not tell the parents.
Okay.
It got detected because of the bulge in her tummy.
Okay.
The father becomes very angry and forces her to get an abortion. Now, obviously, like what you explained just now, the girl has premarital affair. So it is Venus karma as well. Understood. Venus and Jupiter. Now, how about the father who influenced her to have an abortion? Because she was not ready to abort.
She was not ready to abort, but the father should have a father or a mother. It is their moral responsibility to note their child, to watch their child, right?
Yes.
They have to, they have to notice that before itself, before the, while tapering the activities of the daughter itself. Correct?
Yes, so, that's true.
So that is the irresponsibility of the father itself. So the concerned person might have carrying the three karma totally. Venus, Surya and Jupiter.
Okay. No, actually the parents were away from this girl. Anyway, that is not the issue, sir. Like the father has influenced her to go through that process.
Even the parents were away from the girl. The girl who is getting aborted after 2 to 3 months. She will face a severe medical complication, correct?
Yes, yes, she did.
Yes. So the medicine is the area of Surya Bhagavan, correct?
Correct.
So definitely there will be Surya Karma, Jupiter Karma, and especially Venus Karma.
Okay, sir. Okay. Now, I was trying to look at the father's chart, like what caused him to influence the abortion, because in an abortion, he is party to it, because abortion is Jupiter Karma.
Okay.
I was thinking in that perspective. I'll have a check on that.
Yeah, okay. Definitely. So, take an example horoscope that Aries Lagna. Aries Lagna itself as an example. So, Sun is placed in the Lagna itself. What about the concerned status of the Aries Lagna? Sun is exalted. Sun is the fifth lord. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes, with Jupiter Karma.
So Jupiter Karma.
This also indicates a very powerful Jupiter Karma.
Yes.
Very powerful Jupiter Karma. Fifth Lord in the fifth house, fifth Lord in the first house, fifth Lord in the second house, first Lord in the first house, first Lord in the second house, first Lord in the fifth house. So in any that 1 to 5 combination, it will create a very, 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 very powerful Jupiter Karma. When it connects to the fifth house, especially the 1, 2, 5, first lord, second lord, and fifth lord, all the three lords are in the fifth house. It will give more powerful Jupiter karma to the fifth house.
Yes.
Okay.
For Aries Lagna, fifth house is Leo. So that itself gets Jupiter karma. So double Jupiter karma.
And sir, if Mars is also in 10th, exalted, then by aspect, it's also aspect fifth house.
Mars is also
exalted.
So it is aspect in the fifth house. Yes. Yes, it, then, it also it, it yeah it will also influence the Jupiter karma to the fifth
and
house.
By exaltation also it will be increased.
Yes,
10th and 11th both, sir.
Okay. Yes, yes, it will. Take Pisces Lagna as an example. Pisces.
Yes.
Okay. Sir. The Lagna Lord Jupiter is placed in the fifth house. In the fifth house, in the Cancer, Jupiter is exalted. Am I correct? Yes.
Correct.
Right? Lagna Lord and the 10th Lord is exalted in the fifth house. But it will also create a very powerful Jupiter karma. Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I hope we will continue the Jupiter karma in the next class. Almost,
sure, sir.
We will continue the Jupiter karma in the next class. In any clarification in this class regarding this?
Does the 12th house karma, Guru karma, that means Gemini Rashi or Gemini Lagna, will it also influence the Jupiter karma problem in children?
No, I didn't understand your question properly. Why you are including the 12th house?
Because I think she is thinking Taurus is becoming the 12th lord. Taurus carries Jupiter karma like that. She's probably
yes.
No. You need not confuse the Taurus with the Jupiter karma. Take for an example, you take the Gemini ascendant. The Gemini ascendant, okay? In the Gemini ascendant, you consider an example that Venus is placed in the fifth house itself. Shukra is placed in the fifth house itself. The Shukra is the fifth lord, as well as the Shukra is the 12th lord. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
So both Surya karma and Jupiter karma is to the fifth house. Now you can connect that.
Jupiter karma and Surya karma.
Yes.
Okay, sir.
Because 12th lord is also placed in the fifth house. Fifth lord is also placed in the fifth house. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
So it has dual karma.
Dual karma.
Yes, right. So the placements of the planets while connecting the aspect of karma, it needs some practice. Slow by slow practice, it will come. It will come to all of them.
Sir,
okay.
If Venus is also in 10th house, exalted, then he exhibit